Hello everyone, welcome back to ATP Creative Corner. In today's video, I am going to make this brocade purse with a patch pocket inside. Before we begin, please hit that subscribe button if you aren't subscribed already. Now let's get started. For the template, I have taken a rectangular piece of drawing sheet with dimensions 9 inches across 5.5 inches. I am going to fold it in half like this. At the bottom corner, I am going to draw a curved shape like this. Next, I am going to cut the sheet along this curved line like this. Now our template is ready. Using this template, I am going to cut all the fabric pieces. So I have taken two pieces of brocade fabric, two pieces of interfacing, I have taken duck canvas, and two pieces of lining fabric. To begin with, on the wrong side of the main fabric, I am going to place the interfacing like this, and I'll give stitches on the edges. Once done, it'll look something like this. Next, on the lining fabric, I have made a zippered patch pocket. I've already made a video on how you can make a zippered patch pocket for any bag. I'll give the link in the description box below. Next, I've taken a zipper of 7.5 inches length. I'm going to use zipper tabs. For that, I've taken two pieces of brocade fabric and two pieces of lining fabric, four pieces of dimensions, 1.5 inches across 1 inches. On the right side of the zipper, I am going to place this main fabric pieces facing downwards like this. And on the wrong side of the zipper, I'll be placing the lining pieces like this, such that the zipper is sandwiched between them. Now I'll give straight stitches here. Now it's done. Next, on one of the main pieces, I'm going to place the zipper with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'll be using sewing clips to keep them in place. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Next, I'm going to place the lining piece with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Now I'll give a top stitch here. Top stitch is done. Next, on the other piece of the main fabric, I'm going to place the zipper with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Next, I'll keep the other piece of the lining with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Now I'll give top stitch on this side as well. Top stitch is done. Next, I'm going to fold the purse such that the main fabric is facing each other and the lining fabric is facing each other like this. Next, I'm going to place sewing clips such that the seams are one on top of the other like this. Now I'll give a stitch starting from this point all the way around the purse until I reach this point, leaving these 3 inches unstitched. Once done, it looks something like this. Next, I'm going to make notch marks around the curve like this. Now from this 3-inch space, I'm going to turn the purse right side out. Now I'm going to push the rod just on the lining fabric inside and give a straight stitch on top. Now it's done. Now I'll push the lining fabric inside the purse like this. Our purse is ready now. Next, to make the zipper pull, I've taken a zari string and a small piece of brocade fabric. The string is around 5 inches in length and the fabric piece is 1 inches across 2 inches in dimension. Next, I'm going to fold these two sides 1/4 inches on the wrong side of the fabric like this. Next, I'll fold it again with their right sides facing each other like this. Now I'm going to give a stitch on both the sides with 1/4 inch seam allowance. Now it's done. Now I'll cut the seam allowance in half like this. And I'll turn it right side out. Next, I'll fold the string in half like this and I'll insert the open ends into this piece like this and give a top stitch here. Now it's done. Now I'll insert it into the runner like this and make a knot like this. And our zipper pull is ready now. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.